What's up, y'all?
Come get this commentary.
The best on these streets. I'm about to start the club up. Let me see who's here. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Kiva from Come Get This Commentary, and I hope you are having a wonderful week. As I'm recording this, this is Sunday, but I got busy. I ended up stop recording, had to come back record. So yeah, I'm late. However, I still want to get my commentary on it. So as you saw in the first clip, Krishan, I don't even know where that's from. It says Zeus on the wall. I don't watch Zeus, but the clip shows her hitting someone unprovoked based off of them physically hitting her first. She swung and hit somebody based off of her words. I only played that clip because I saw it on TikTok and I said, you know what? She has a history of swinging on people based off of words, and if she don't like how you talking to her, and that is just not how life moves. But anyway, as you'll see in the next clip, James showed his face, which by now I'm sure all of you. So here we see him congratulating his friend, giving his friend all the accolades. And what do y'all think? Could it be a little swole? I mean, this, we see him, but honestly, I would like to see a straight forward pic of him. Is his teeth fixed? You know, does he still have his gap? Is it closed more? I mean, I can't really determine anything about his face. So you let me know down in the comments, what are your thoughts? He was at one of his friends' birthday parties or celebrations or something to that nature. But at the end of the day, we can't fully tell if perhaps he's swollen or what, but his face does look normal, okay? I still stand on what I said in my previous commentary. I do believe that Krishan hit him. Again, I'll state, I believe Tamar, I believe, what is it, LaTroy, and I believe her manager. When my thing is, especially for Tamar and her manager, I'm not really well versed in LaTroy, but I think all three of them, okay, have way more to lose and a reputation that would be detrimental to their livelihood almost overnight if in fact they lied. And he backed up what he said by stating, if you want to go pull the 911 call, pull it. So if you don't know how to go get a 911 call, it's through FOIA, Freedom of Information Act. It is not free. I'm not paying for it. Somebody might, however, it's there. And I think by him stating, go get it, he knows someone could possibly go get it. So why risk that one person or several people that actually pay for it and pull it up only to say there was no call placed that day? Now, at the end of the day, it is still speculation because we don't have the 911 call out. We never saw pics of James. But yes, I'll be honest. On one hand, it's like, I wanted to see. Not because to make fun of you, but it just gave a little bit more validation to the story. But at the end of the day, the people's court will decide what they believe and what they won't. Some believe, some don't. I believe she did it. It is what it is. But everyone seems to be moving on. They seem to be living a life. Tamar had a little concert, or she did. Not a little. I'm not trying to belittle. I hate when people say had a little something. So I don't want that to be seen like I'm putting down her concert. But she had some event. She went live for like about 2 minutes and was like in the elevator, like kind of celebrating. Old boy said he spoke his piece, which I didn't understand why he needed to explain why he told. Though I can understand people may say, well, why did you jump on here and tell? What if they didn't want anyone to know? But as we saw in the tweets, he didn't like Krishan. He's tweeted a lot of fuck shit about her, like everyone else. His tweets were no different than the other fuck shit that gets tweeted about her. So I don't hold it against him. He has an opinion about the girl. He ain't never been a fan. And it is what it is. However, I guess the infamous rock tards. And when I say rock tards, I'm talking about those that have an unhealthy obsession with her and wanting to defend her to the point where you would make a death threat, where you would threaten harm upon him based off of him telling his story, right? So that is a rock tard to me. A fan of Krishan that has self-control and thinks logically and can still voice their opinion in an adult manner, you are not a rock tard, because anybody can be a rock tard for any superstar, okay? He felt some kind of way that he's being dragged left and right. I think he even posted that he had surgery. You know, I hope he overcomes that. But everyone does seem to be moving on. Now, will they file charges? And I think the only one who can file the charges would be James, and they would possibly be witnesses to it. Perhaps he doesn't want to file charges anymore. Again, speculating. We don't know what's happening behind the scenes. Preferably, I say if he's going to do it, let it come out when it hit the courts. Talking about it, letting the left hand know what the right hand doing, can sometimes backfire. Just do what you do, and when it pop up, it pop up. But I could almost see where he like, I'm just fuck it, you know. My teeth got fixed. I'm in a good place. You know, I'm healed up. We moving on. And they may never, ever do business with her again, which I don't think they will. I think the ties of Tamar wanting to be like auntie to her is probably washed up and gone, because they did talk about her like a dog. I think that's like a clean cut. Everybody went their way. Wasn't no money exchange. And pretty much they proved, in my opinion, what they said. The screenshots of the text messages show that they were getting tickets. That they were getting tickets to come as a guest, okay? Everyone stated she was not performing. Tamar said my sister was coming to perform. If she was going to have her perform, she would have had some paperwork signed. There would have been some compensation. So at the end of the day, everyone can actually just walk away if they feel like it, but we shall see. So let's get into the next clip with Krishan. She seems to have met somebody, and it's crazy. Already is some drama around this young man. But let's get into the next clip, and then we'll talk about it. So here, somebody called Krishan out at Target doing regular stuff that regular people do. Go shopping. And we're going to see them be hand in hand, picking up a few items, doing normal things. And she looks like she's moving on and moving past everything as well. And so here we saw Krishan, which looked like she's in her studio. And she know we love seeing the baby. And again, he's in a snowsuit. I'm telling y'all, that stresses me out that this baby has been in a snowsuit since birth. I just don't understand why. But that's neither here nor there. It is good seeing him. She was just basically talking about her and the baby, things of that nature. And again, she looks like she's moving on. Like, you know, what's done is done, or what ain't done ain't done. But she a mama. She got to hit that studio. She got to make this music, put up that content. And that's what it looked like she is doing. Just on her mom tings, as they say.
Tell them what we're doing, Ken. Hey.
Come on now. We don't have
to
talk. What you gonna do?
We
talking bad.
Say hi.
And hey, what the people been wanting, ain't it? You know what I'm saying? I promise you, I'm gonna bring out a side of Miss Malone that ain't nobody ever done that.
Yeah.
Comment below. Have y'all watched the interview? I've saw multiple clips, but I really want to sit down, watch the interview, take my notes, and give my commentary on it. Let me know, do you think it was a good interview? Did you see Krishan in a different light? Did you understand her a little more? Or was it relatively the same interview that she had with Jason Lee? Basically all the same answers. But I do like that she looks happy here. Krishan deserves her happiness, okay? She deserves to continue
to grow into her craft of whatever her career is going to be. And I want to see her doing good. She's a mom, you know, and even if she wasn't a mom, she's a young woman, a young Black woman. So I hope this incident is going to change her for the better. I mean, we can only wait and see, but definitely comment below. Let me know, did you watch the interview? And on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the worst, 10 being the best, let me know what you thought about it.
So look, we about to press play. Say hi to 60,000 motherfuckers.
60,000?
Yeah, it's going up.
You are lying.
I'm not.
Wow!
That's crazy.
Yo, Kim, shut up, yo.
That's crazy. I only seen like 6,000 online.
I gotta tell you something, y'all. I just bought an island. But it's not the Blue Rock Island no more. Guess what it's called? Krishan.
So that's all for this video. Like I said, Krishan, we all see she looked like she's moving on. She's getting her interviews done. She's in the studio, shopping, you know. At this point, it is what it is. Again, like I said, I want to see this young lady succeed, okay? She is, I believe, 23, 24. She's still at that age where she can turn all of this around. Her talent for her genre is out there. They love her. She turned things up. She just has a lot of things to work on. And I do have some thoughts, some opinions about the new alleged boo. He looks like Bae. He sound like he might be Bae. She blushed when she talked about Bae. But I got my thoughts, and I'll see you in the next video with those. Hopefully, you have already hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and comment it down below. Bye.
Come get this commentary.